back on full of energy. Why full of energy? Because we are studying about energy as from where do we get it. Today in our session, this is our second session of science class 6. The name of the chapter is component of food. Now we have understood that from where do we get carbohydrates? Let's recall, quick revision. We get carbohydrates from the food like bread, potato, rice, and it is a quick energy giving food. Thereafter we have studied about protein. Protein is very much important for our body. Why? Because it helps in growing and repairing the body. And we get protein from dal, pulses, cereals, etc. As well as the non-vegetarian foods like fish and eggs. Thereafter, we have studied about the fat. It is also essential for our body as it gives energy too. We get fats from oil, ghee, cheese, butter, etc. We have also talked about the vitamins. They are equally important and they play an important role in our life. They protect us from the diseases. Okay? As protein repairs the food, they protect us from the diseases. So we have to eat them too. Minerals is also equally important. We have also studied about water and roughness. But its brief description we are going to study now. What the water and the roughage. Look, water is very much important for our body as it takes raw materials with it. Which type of raw material? Raw material which is not good for our organ as we intake our food. Our food has both the quantities in equal amounts. We can even say some foods are essential for our organs, some aren't. So water now plays an important role. Water just takes all unwanted materials from the blood and from the body, blood whatever, and just throw them out of the body in the form of feces or urine. Okay? And roughage, let me give you an example. Have you seen your mama cleaning the utensils? She has a green color Scotch Brite. It is very rough. Okay, when she cleans up the utensils become clean. And all the strains means dark. Whatever food we eat, now there are the leftover food in the village. This thing, plates. So she used to clean the plate with the help of that Scotch Brite. In the same way, as it is rough and if you just hold that Scotch Brite in your hands, just today do it, okay? Go into the kitchen and have that Scotch Brite. As you will be having that Scotch Brite in your hand, you just touch it. It has a very rough surface. As you soak it into the water and you just do like squeezing it, you will find that water comes down, okay? As you just put it inside the water, then it will also take the water in it. This, like this only, this roughage works. Inside our body, it works like a dietary fibers. It just sucks all the unwanted material and throws them out through our large intestine outside the body via anus. I hope this is clear to you. So these were the nutrients we have discussed. If you remember that in the beginning, I told you that we are going to do even the test. By the test, you will come to know in which food which nutrient is present. Therefore, in today's content, we are going to cover up about the test of carbohydrates, protein, fats, as well as diseases also we are going to discuss. Okay? Let's see our first test. Now our first test is for the test of carbohydrates. Now in this, what do you have to do? You have to just here take one bottle of iodine solution. Which solution you will take? Iodine solution. Ready, beta? Okay, and take a dropper also. What will you take? Dropper. And take a bowl of rice. Because you have to check for carbohydrates, and carbohydrate contains starch. Now, which foods have starch? The food like potato, rice, and bread, they have starch present in it. So, you are going to see whether the rice contains starch or not. Why rice? Because in our example, we have taken rice. You can do this example even at your home. Okay? Now, we have taken a bowl of rice. Ready? Now, as you collect all three things, now what will you going to do? You just take a bowl of rice as well as what will you going to take? Iodine solution in a small bottle as well as the dropper. Now you just use the dropper, take few amount of iodine solution in it. Take 5 ml or 2 ml, that is enough. Just with the help of that dropper, just take that iodine solution and pour a pinch by pinch into the drop by drop into the bowl of rice. Now the color of rice is white, you know that. Okay, and as soon as you are going to drop this thing, iodine solution in the rice, so what will going to happen? White rice will change and it will become black blue rice. What does it mean? It means that as from white color, the color has been changed to black blue. It means rice contains the starch. Same thing you can repeat even with the bread or the potato. Potato that you have in your home. Just cut down the potato and just have a drop of iodine solution. If it changes its color, it means it contains the starch. If it is not able to change the color, it means it doesn't have the starch. I think this is quite clear to you. I have even written over here, you can write. What do you have to add? That I have written, even the color changes. And yes, suppose I'll give you one more example so you will be able to understand the difference. You like enjoying eating the rice? So for this experiment to check whether it contains starch or not, do one more thing. Just have small quantity of rice. Chew it inside your mouth over this area near your jaws. Okay. Chew it. Thereafter spit it out in a bowl. And thereby just add the iodine solution. In which portion? Remember this thing. In which portion you are going to add the portion which had been chewed inside your mouth? You take two bowls. One raw rice. Raw rice means food, the boiled one. Okay? In another, chewed rice. Now put the iodine solution in both. In raw rice as well as in chewed rice. So, the rice which had been chewed inside your mouth. One is, this is your second example, okay? Make sure you see the whole video, then only you can understand. Okay, beta? Here, the experiment was quite different. Here, we are taking two different rice. How? One is cooked or boiled rice. Boiled rice. And here we have taken chewed rice. Now, as soon as you are going to draw a iodine solution, this rice will change its color into black blue. Here, color will be black blue. And here, do you know? There is no change, beta. No change at all. The chewed rice will remain same in color. That is white. Which color? White. Now white. The reason behind that is, as we eat the rice, as we chew it, the rice inside our mouth, the starch breakdowns. As soon as we just take a bite of rice, the starch immediately starts working and it breaks down with the help of saliva present inside the mouth. So starch remains inside and what comes out? Nothing. There is no nutrient then present in it. That's why the color remains the same. Don't forget to write it out. You should know. As in the beginning only, I told you, you are studying science. And science is all about W-H-Y. Why? If I am delivering you something, so you should be able to understand why it had happened. What is the reason behind that? That should be your aim to understand when you are sitting in a science class. And if you just go on understanding, that is not of use. Now, you will definitely going to look for every food. And you can even to tell to your parents or your friends, Mama, look, a potato has a starch. Then Mama says, how come you know? So you can do this experiment at home even. Okay? So this was about the carbohydrates. Let us study about test of protein. Now you have to test for protein. Look, in this experiment, we don't need any of the extra things required for tasting. But when we are talking about the protein, we need the materials. We need a test tube. Test tube is white in color. Okay, you would have seen, your teacher would have shown you, okay, in your lab. White color test tube is there and they are very sensitive because they are made up of glass. Without the permission of teacher, you should not touch that things. Okay. So in this experiment, especially when we have to check whether the food have present this thing protein or not. So in such condition, what do you want to have? What are your requirements? You need a test tube. You need a copper sulfate solution. It's a solution. Copper sulfate in caustic soda. Caustic soda is NaOH. That is sodium hydroxide. When you will reach in your further classes, you come to know what are these chemicals are and what are their formulas, how they are made up of. In this class, what is important? Important is to understand for testing which nutrient, what are your requirements. So, what do we have required for the checking of or for the testing of protein is, we need to have a test tube, we need copper sulfate solution, we need NaOH, that is caustic soda, as well as sodium hydroxide, it's another name. We need to have water too. Okay? Now, we have taken all these things. Now, what we are going to do? In a test tube, we will take some food. Okay? We'll take some food in a test tube. And try to take two test tubes. In one test tube, you have put some food. I have written over here. Add a small quantity or a pinch of food inside the test tube. In other test tube you have with you copper sulfate. Okay. Listen, you should take a diluted form of these chemicals. Now what do you mean by dilute? That the chemicals are made by two things. Some chemicals are acidic in nature, some have base. But before that, they are concentrated as well as dilute. The concentrated chemicals has a very high quality of flaming. Okay, they are very dangerous to you even. You should not touch such assets without anyone's permission. So it becomes necessary you to understand before touching any of the thing inside the laboratory, you must ask your teacher. So making this solution to dilute, we have to add water to them. After adding the water and made it, what do we make? We made the concentration to dilute. We have diluted the chemical. Now what we have to do? In one test tube, we have to pour, or drop by drop, we have to put the chemical inside the food, and as soon as it undergoes this process, the color of the food like you can take dal, it's fine, its color will change into purple, and this purple shows that it should be purple in color, that there is protein present in that. Same thing we can do with non-vegetarian food like chicken or whatever you want to take, you may. I think this is also clear to you. Beta, have your eyes as well as your key should be open. Because once you just go into it. You think this, that this will going to move with you throughout your life. Because you have to eat food for getting energy. So these are the parts you don't have to mug up. Okay, you just memorize. Memorize in what sense? Ki you know these things. If someone asks you, you can immediately answer them. Fine. Now, on moving to our next. Now we are going to do the test of fats. I hope you would be enjoying. Why? Because you haven't done this thing before. This is your first time. Why? Because you are now totally in the NCERT syllabus. NCERT syllabus is a which type of syllabus? It is an Indian level syllabus. Okay, so now you will be moving towards the laboratory work. Okay, you will be able to do such experiments by on your own. Ready? In school, we can perform it in more better way, and we'll do so. Okay, fine. Let's check it out for facts. Look, I'll permit you to do this alone at your home. But for these two things, you need me or your mama or your papa. Kindly don't do these things alone. Okay? But you can tell to others ki what are the changes takes place by what you come to know that it is a that carbohydrate is present in a particular vegetable or a fruit. Now let's move on to the fats. How come we know that fat is present in a particular food? Very easy. In this, take a paper. Okay? In that paper, crush some chips. Just crush it out. Chips you can take, ghee you can take, whatever you want to take. Ghee you don't have to crush, neither or oil you have to. So chips, you just crush it in the paper, then hold the paper into your hand and ask someone to stand behind that. You wouldn't be able to see properly. It will be little bit blur, or what you can see very little part, means partially. That is also called transuculant. You will going to learn more in further classes what are opaque substance or transparent or transuculant. Even you have studied in your 5th standard too. But this we can do with the what you can do this thing? With the experiment of paper, you can attempt this thing. So we have already studied about this. Now we have even understood how can we test for carbohydrates or the protein, even the thing. What we have checked? Fats even we have seen. Now, beta, let me teach you with a diagram that what exactly. There is one man standing over here. Now, this is what? This is the nutrients. Okay? Now, you can tell or you can see over here on the board, they can be known as the sun. Sun, if somebody asks you what is the most important thing, so what will you say around you? It's sun. Sun gives us sunlight. We never ask for anything, never ask any money for that. Okay? Now, nutrients is made up of vitamins and minerals. Ready? Then protein. Roughage and water. Very important, huh? Roughage is also called a dietary fiber. The foods like orange, it's very good. Okay? You should eat it. Contain maximum dietary fiber. Or Hindi mein usko bolte hain reshe wale fruits. Okay? Foods like orange, even grapes, etc. Okay? Now, daily, in your breakfast, daily have a food which contain dietary fiber. Let me write for you over here. They are called diet fruits. Fine? And water in it. Then what next we have? We have the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates. And each nutrient has their specific fat function. Is there anything remaining? Yes, fats remain. They are equally important, Amita. Rather, very much important. Fine? So, nutrient is made up of all these things. And if we again revise it, so for quick energy, we need to have carbohydrates. For maintenance of body or for the repair of body, we need to have proteins. For removing the waste material from the body or for soaking the waste material, we need to have roughage as well as the water. Vitamin and minerals make us free from diseases. So this was the part you must be aware of. Okay? Now, as we have discussed about all the vitamins, now the time has come to tell you something more about them and what are the diseases which I have discussed very fast that we are going to discuss in this session about the diseases and how they can be cured, even what are their symptoms, how come we know that we are suffering from very disease. So, before getting inside the chapter, let's understand beta. Beta, if you suffer with any of the problem, small stomach ache is there or whatever is there, you must inform to your parents immediately, okay? Don't take it as granted. If you are in school, inform your teacher, okay? Take everything very seriously. But don't make false stomach ache. Sometimes our homework is incomplete, then the pain, the ache starts inside our stomach. It's better to speak the truth. And truth is like, sorry ma'am, today my work is incomplete because I was ill. Even, ma'am, I was not liking the subject, the work which you have given me. I was bored. That's why I didn't attend. Okay? One truth makes a prosperous life. World, okay, and life makes a world very, very difficult. Okay, so never speak the lie. lies always speak the truth. Let's move on to the vitamins part. As I told you, there are many the same nutrients in your food. But when we talk about vitamin and minerals, vitamin, you know, they can keep us disease free. They have a very important role. Fine, Peter. Minerals we need in small quantity, but they help in building up our body. Now let's see. Various types of vitamins are there, such as vitamin A, B complex, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K. There are various types of vitamins. What are they? Different types of vitamins. Now, what do we get from different vitamins? This is as simple as, what do you get when you come to school? You get bulk of knowledge. You get the honesty. You get the prosperity. In the same way, they have certain work. Okay, they provide certain energy to the body. Now, from which fruit, vegetable or food we get the vitamins? Fine, let's see. Vitamin B. If the person is lacking behind with vitamin B, he or she has to take milk in his diet. It is rich in vitamin B. Even pulses, cereals, as well as if you are non-vegetarian, you may have meat. Meat such as chicken, pork, etc. So these are the food, even more than this, are rich in vitamin B. By this vitamin B gets over. Now suppose you need to have vitamin A. So all the green leafy food has maximum vitamin A, even the milk. I told you in last lecture means in lesson 1, that there is one complete food which consists of maximum, almost all the nutrients, that is milk. And if you just see over here, you will going to find milk in every vitamin, whether it's A, B, K, E, whatever, etc. So if you want to have vitamin A, you must eat green vegetables, milk, carrot, papaya, fish, etc. Let me tell you, fish is a non-vegetarian, okay? Now, if you want vitamin C, so you should have in your diet amla, then lemon. They are rich in vitamin C. So, fruits like lemon, orange, amla, they all have maximum amount of vitamin C. Now, vitamin D. Milk, egg, fish, even the sunlight. Sunlight is also the source of vitamin D. But at what time? At dawn time, we have to stand in the sunlight. Dawn means around 5 to 6 o'clock a.m. rather, in the morning, early in the morning. If you want natural vitamin D, just go and stand under the shade or under the sunshine. Don't forget, it's AM, not the PM. It's AM. Vitamin D you can directly get from the sunlight. Nowadays, what hospitals or what doctors are saying, that human body is lagging behind in two things. One is vitamin D and the other one is B12. As we are beta vegetarian, the people who are totally vegetarian, there is nothing which can give B12 to our body except fish. Fish is the main source. So we need to have B12. That's why from the beginning, right from the childhood, you must have a habit of eating all the cereal, pulses, then you can be safe from B12 deficiency. Now I hope you would have understood all these things, and from where you get which food you get a particular vitamin. If you go to a doctor, you have something, some stomach ache is there or headache is there. If the doctor suggests you, okay, you are lacking behind in vitamin D, so immediately it will going to click you out that in your diet you have to increase what? You have to increase milk in your day-to-day life, twice a day, 3 times a day is a very good thing, huh, beta? As well as you should stand outside in sunlight around 5 or 6 a.m. Now, here I hope you would have understood about all these vitamins and from where we get it. Just copy down in your notebook, fine? Now, let's move on to this thing. Look, this topic is very important. Why? Because it is dealing with our own body. Let's see. Here, the heading is given vitamin and mineral. They are coming in the category of vitamin and minerals. Here, deficiency disease. If vitamin A misses, so what type of deficiency you could suffer with? And what are their symptoms? Even I'll let you know how you can cure it up. First, let's see. Suppose you are lagging behind with vitamin A. Don't forget, it will be cured by such things. Milk, meat, etc. Fine? So, if your body is lagging behind with the nutrient called vitamin A, so what type of disease you will suffer with? You will be having loss of vision. Vision means you cannot see. As I can see right now, as my age will grow and I have a lackness of vitamin A, so can be possible in my old age, I cannot see or I can see only partial. Partial means half. Either it will be totally blind, you can see here, poor vision, you cannot see, you have to just blink your eye, try to focus, but you cannot. Why? Because you are suffering from lackness of vitamin B, even, sorry, vitamin A. Even you can talk to your elders, are you able to see properly? If they say no, so it means they are suffering from vitamin A. Nowadays, right from the childhood, you have the spectacles. Why? Because we are not taking care of our body, we are lagging behind with vitamin A. To improve that, we should have these things in our diet, especially the green vegetables. Vegetables like coriander leaf. Okay? I'm not saying that spectacles are bad. We have to wear. There are many other reasons too. Not only that, but this can be one of the reasons. So, lackness of vitamin A, there will be what situation? Loss of vision. This is a disease. The name of the disease and what are the symptoms? How come you know? There will be a loss of vision or partial or complete blind. There will be a complete blind. It means you are not able to see anything at all. Next is vitamin B1. Now by the lackness of vitamin B1, you can suffer with the disease beriberi. The name of the disease is beriberi. Now what happens in this? Our muscles cramps. Cramps matlab? There is an ache. What there is? Ache. Okay? So there is a weak muscles and very little energy to work. Every time you feel tired, very dizzy, you don't want to work, there is no interest in study. You never know. If you feel so now, nowadays it is happening very much. You should inform everyone. Fine? So, it means you are lagging behind with vitamin B1. That's why you are suffering from beriberi. Next we have what? Vitamin C. If you lag behind with vitamin C, you will suffer from the disease named scurvy. What is the name of the disease? Scurvy. It means there will be bleeding gums. What do you mean by gums? If you can see my mouth, see over here, teeth. Teeth are attached with pink color material that are called gums. So it will bleed. If you are suffering from scurvy or lacking behind with vitamin C, then gums will bleed. Even wounds take longer time to heal. Now, from there it starts bleeding. That is called wound. And wound, it takes time to be covered or to be okay. Why? Because you are lacking behind with the vitamin C. Now, vitamin D, you can suffer from disease like rickets. In rickets, what happens? Bone becomes soft or it bends. For example, you can see your leg. You would have seen the people who doesn't have the straight leg. They have a curve in their leg. Even the hands like this it becomes. Okay? In which condition it becomes like this? When you are lacking behind with vitamin D. Fine? Now next, calcium. Calcium, you would be aware of, is very much important for your bone, for rather a strong bone. So which disease you will suffer with? Bone and tooth decay. Even your tooth will soon fall down. Even bone, you cannot have a strong or a straight bone. There can be the lumps in your bones. So the symptoms are weak bones or decay tooth. Even next, iodine. Now, due to the lightness of iodine we can also say it as a salt, a good salt, natural salt. So, with the lightness of iodine, you may suffer with goiter. You would have seen mumps, the friends of yours in a class, they mainly suffer in the season like rainy season. You got a mumps, your neck area, this area swells up. Even sometimes your cheek swells up and even it pains. So what happens? This is called goiter. But this goiter is a major issue of Lassen disease. So goiter, what happens? What are the symptoms? As I told you, that glands around the neck swollen, mental disability in children. Mental disability means the children mind doesn't work properly due to the lightness of iodine. They react partially as they get angry or they are not present. Physically they are, but mentally they aren't. It is also a part of iodine. Next we have iron. Iron is a blood molecule. Inside our body, iron is known as blood.